Charlize Theron will star as Megyn Kelly in a new movie about the women who worked at Fox News under its disgraced former chairman Roger Ailes, according to multiple reports. The presently untitled project was written by The Big Short screenwriter Charles Rudolph and is being produced by Annapurna, the same production company currently filming a Dick Cheney biopic starring Christian Bale, according to The Hollywood Reporter. Theron, 42, is reportedly set to play Kelly, 47, a former lawyer who worked at Fox News for 10 years and became a superstar at the network hosting the hit series The Kelly Files. In her memoir Settle for More, Kelly detailed the UAL harassment she said she endured while working for Ailes. Ailes was accused of similar behavior by numerous women at Fox News, which he vehemently denied until his death in May 2017. Kelly claimed in her book that after months of harassment, the media tycoon crossed a new line in January 2006 when he grabbed her and repeatedly tried to kiss her. Upon shoving him away, Kelly alleged that Ailes asked her the ominous question of "When is your contract up?" before trying to kiss her for a third time. Related, Charlize Theron gained close to 50 pounds for new role in Tully, got hit pretty hard with depression. Kelly said she never succumbed to any of his advances that she claimed stopped after 6 months once she reported Ailes' behavior to her supervisor. She left Fox News in 2017 and signed a deal with NBC News. Her accusation came just months after former Fox News anchor Gretchen Carlson filed a UAL harassment suit against Ailes. He denied all accusations of harassment against Carlson as well. When Carlson's lawsuit went public, Kelly wrote that she was pressured to put out a positive statement about Ailes but refused. Greta Van Susteren defended Ailes in the wake of the lawsuit but went back on her support of Ailes after her departure from the network in September. Ailes resigned from Fox News in July 2016 and received $40 million in an exit agreement. He just 3 days after his 77th birthday last year after he accidentally fell and hit his head at home.